the Catalan independent movement has shown us a lot of things. First of all, the importance of the solidarity. To win, we have seen that we need also the Spanish working class. We need to be united against the Spanish regime, because the Spanish regime is attacking, is hitting the Catalan working class, but also the Spanish working class. So we need to build bridges of solidarity, because the working class struggle is international. So we don't only need to be united with the Spanish working class, also with the Spanish, with the working class around the world. The second point is that the working class needs to be organized under its own political strategy. We have seen how useful it is to organize a general strike for the struggle, but also we have seen how afraid is the bourgeoisie, also the Catalan bourgeoisie, when we use this type of weapons, when we organize ourselves and we organize a general strike, when we know that we have the power. Third, that there's no any type of independence movement without social movement, without laboral rights movement, without the students movement, without feminism, without migrant movement. There's no, because the independence of Catalonia, it's not about changing our ID card. It's not about that. It's about build another type of society. So we need to connect, to link every struggle for a future better society. The fourth point is the limits of the reformism. As you know, we have Podemos in the Spanish state. They are not supporting us. Why not? Because first of all, they know that if they support us, they will lose votes around the Spanish state. And the second reason is that the reformist is never is going to challenge the Spanish regime. So we need to build a revolutionary strategy and not follow anymore the reformism. The fifth point is that how the Spanish bourgeoisie is using Vox, the new far-right party, to smash the Catalan movement. Vox was created 7 years ago. 7 years ago. But why now is so powerful? Why? Because the Spanish bourgeoisie gave them a lot of space. The Vox is the personal accusation against the Catalan political prisoners. So the Vox is using this space to develop their own campaign. And now in the last elections, they got 10% of the votes in the Spanish state. So we cannot give to the far-right parties any type of a space, because they are going to use it to grow up. We have to smash them. Also, if we analyze the electoral results, you can see how Vox get the majority of the votes in the richest neighborhoods, not in the working class neighborhoods. So that show us how the Spanish bourgeoisie that had connections with the Franco dictatorship is using the far-right parties to smash and to finish against the Catalan independence movement. And to finish, I want to say that sometimes the European Union It's like we are defending the human rights and the democratic rights, and who is against the European Union is crazy people against human rights. But we can see how after the referendum, when the Spanish state sent to cut the police to hit the people in Catalonia who was voting, the European Union was always in the side of the Spanish regime. They didn't with the human rights, with the democratic rights. They were supporting the Spanish regime that was hitting people that was voting. So we cannot say that the European Union is the same of the democratic and human rights. And also we can see what is doing the European Union in the borders. So no, there are more options than the far right or supporting yes the European Union. We need to build another proposal, a proposal from the anti-capitalism and against every type of oppression and exploitation. So, as a revolutionary from Spain said, we have a new world in our hands and in our heads, and now is the time to build it. So smash the far right, smash the national oppression, and smash the capitalism. Thank you.